Okay, so I hear from atheists or agnostics a lot that it must be just so horrifying growing up in a Christian household, a traditional Christian household that teaches traditional concepts of the afterlife and heaven and hell, that Christian children just must be scarred and terrified because growing up at some point in their home and through their childhood or their youth, they're going to be taught about heaven and specifically about hell and how this idea that one day they're going to die and face justice and they might have to carry the weight of their sin for all eternity, that this should just be horrifying, and Christian parents shouldn't be allowed to teach their children until their kids are 18, and what terrible child abuse it is to hear that that hell might exist, or that for a kid to learn that they could possibly go to hell. It's this all just really silly, isn't it? I mean, I can flip this right back on the atheist. I mean, do you go to your child when they're 5 years old and tell them, one of these days you're going to die and cease to exist? That's it. There's no afterlife. There's no hope. And 500 years from now, you're not even going to be remembered. It will be as if you never existed. And that eternal lack of existing, that, you know, one day you will not be remembered and no one will, you know, that renders everything in your life currently kind of meaningless. Because what can you have? What can you obtain that you're not ultimately going to lose anyway? Now, my point is not, which is worse, existence list of the atheism or the hell of the belief of the theist, but just this, that with Christianity, there's hope. You see, the atheist cannot help but go to his child and say, one day you're going to die, and that's it. You'll cease to exist forever. I mean, that's a horrifying thought, but it's a horrifying thought without any hope. Now, you can debate whether you decide the idea of the justice of hell or the existence list of the atheist. You can decide for yourself which is worse. But at least with a Christian, you can go to your kid and say, yes, when we die, we have to face the justice that our sins deserve, but there is hope. Christ has died for us, and we can have forgiveness and mercy and be accepted into God's family. You tell me which one's more scarring.